number seven, yeah.
We just had a call from Louise from back here, Brisbane.
Good.
You got a bat stuck in you?
We do.
That's a good idea.
Well, my wife wanted to have a crack at getting him out, and I said, no, it's too dangerous, this thing.
Bad luck so far.
What?
Big fish.
Oh, that's really
cool. We're going to have to cut your net, but it won't be, at least it's not in the middle.
That's alright.
Yeah.
It's just going to be cut, has to be cut.
He's really, really stuck in there. It has to be kind of, you have to sort of, like I've seen people put sort of polythene pipe and kind of like a dome and have it nice and tight, and if they do land on it, they just kind of bounce back off again.
Yeah.
We'll have to try and do that then.
He's kind of just sunk straight through the middle of it, isn't he?
Little sleeves and gloves and everything, or else.
Put sort of big scissors I can use. Yeah, gloves. I've got very sharp secretary.
It's okay. Oh, thank you.
Yep, so that's his head free. Do you want to hold him behind his neck and we'll just...
I'm going to try and hook that onto my...
Jeans?
Yep.
That is one in my eye.
Okay.
Oh. Almost there.
It's amazing how entangled they get.
I think that's... Do you want to just check him?
Yeah, I think that's all of it.
Okay. We'll put the towel around him.
Come here, hook your foot on there.
Keep him upside down because that's what he likes. Lying down, where's his head?
As long as his head's out so he's not getting suffocated, he'll be alright. Yeah, there's his head. You alright now? You alright?
Okay.
Load it up. Would you have any tape, Michael?
We're just sucking the fish out. Oh, we're going straight into the
pump. Oh no!
Well, thanks for that, eh?
Yeah, thanks for calling in it.
Put them out of the sun.
But they recommend starting. Hi, guys!
God bless you. No, thank you. See you on fire, right?